Former Ultimate Fighting Championship UFC Light Heavyweight Champion John Jones failed his UFC 214 pre-fight drug test back in July, which returned positive for anabolic steroids tarenabol in his scheduled urine screening. As expected, his B sample also returned hot. That overturned his technical knockout win over Daniel Cormier to a no contest and left Bones provisionally suspended by United States Anti-Doping Agency USADA, though it may take several months to secure a disciplinary hearing. Related Dana White: John Jones couldn't handle the pressure of being champ. UFC Vice President of Athlete Health and Performance, Jeff Nowitzki, explains the process to MMA Fighting. The headline and corresponding article took excerpts from an interview I did last week, where I was asked about the status of John Jones' pending case. I indicated that John's camp, the UFC and USADA were all working hard and together to determine the source of the prohibited substance in Jen's system. That is still the case. I stated that this is often a lengthy process that can take up to several months to complete, but that possible sanctions based on the findings of a completed case ranged from a multi-year suspension to a minimal or no-fault sanction if an unavoidable ingestion of the prohibited substance was determined. While all parties are hoping to find evidence of the unintentional or unavoidable use of the prohibited substance, at no time during the interview did I indicate that there were developments leading in that direction, as was the inference of the headline. Nowitzki was responding to what he claims were misleading media reports. Jones' crushed manager, Malki Kawa, insists Jones was the victim of a tainted supplement and that Bones, who already served a previous suspension for contaminated dick pills, would never intentionally game the system. Not everyone is convinced. For the time being, there isn't much anyone can do except sit around and comment recklessly. Hopefully Jones can plead his case before the holidays so we can get the UFC light heavyweight division back on its feet. Starting here.